And we're back, everyone, for RaleigHype Plays Alan Wake. And I'm very excited for this next episode, because it's not my favorite episode out of the six that there are, I really like three. Three is the build-up to four. And four is my favorite. Five and six are, like, finishing stories, I guess. Oh, well, you'll see. Ruining it. Okay, continue.
Previously on Alan Wake, Alice has been kidnapped.
Right, we need that much.
Alice?
You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife again.
I can't tell anyone except my agent, right. Barry.
Barry believes us. Because he saw it.
I'm worried that you're not right in the head.
The ransom is a manuscript I supposedly wrote that's coming true before my eyes.
It happened just the way it was on
Rusty's
that page.
Dead.
So fat. Dark.
I have found only a few scattered pages.
I want the entire manuscript.
The deadline is in 2 days.
I found Mr. Wake.
Oh no.
Good.
And we're being led into a trap. Like a spider web.
How did she get her hands on the manuscript anyway?
And
I don't know.
Dark,
she's resourceful.
I don't know what's called. The dark, I'll just say the darkness is like in the
Listen,
center.
I found out all sorts of interesting stuff while I was digging around.
Yeah.
Mr. Wake, it's Sheriff Breaker. We have an FBI agent here, Agent Nightingale.
FBI?
He's anxious to see you. You'd better come to the station.
Okay, I'll be right over, Sheriff.
After, of course, the craziness.
Let's make this quick,
with this
huh?
trap, which is definitely a trap, you know, totally, definitely
Help you
a
folks?
Trap.
Name's Randolph. I'm the manager.
We're looking for Rose. Works as a waitress down at the diner.
Rose, sure, nice girl. Who wants to know?
I'm Alan Wake.
The writer, huh? I heard on the radio you were visiting. Well, I'll show you her
okay.
trailer.
So just follow
Rose
him to the trailer.
A nice girl.
Of doom.
On time.
As I was saying, Al,
well,
this
Barry tells me a story.
Of weird stuff from the local
you know what I just realized? I don't have any of the
this
ammo I did from last
crazy.
Episode.
Disappearances,
that bugs
mysterious
me.
Deaths,
like,
urban legends.
I know Barry's talking, but
and
think about it. Like,
this,
you would think,
most of this stuff
after the crazy night Alan's
Lake.
Had,
well,
crazy several
wrong,
nights, you know, because
right.
that was the second
the
time that
the lake was a doorway to the
craziness.
God-fearing type myself.
You think, like, on the way here, he would have been Barry. He's like, Barry.
Anyway,
we need to go get some new clothing. He's like, and Barry's
Thomas
like,
Zane.
Why is that on?
Some of the articles I found.
And Barry's like, I need bigger pockets. I need to put all these fucking,
I ran a bunch of searches,
fucking,
find a single thing he wrote.
You know, the guns
Zane
and like flares,
so
you know,
so
flashlight batteries.
Called Diver's Isle, but the
volcano
but no, under the
I'm
lake
just wearing this dumb
and
jacket.
Zane went down with the island.
Yeah, how about that?
Anyways,
morning,
Barry's talking about
the
local news.
But it would take
local
a tornado to lift something
history
like that.
Of the.
We're damn lucky it didn't crush any of the
what
trailers.
Is it? I forgot the name of the town. Oh no. Okay. We're almost there.
It gets better. A local girl, Barbara Jagger, drowned in Cauldron Lake just a week earlier. They were lovers.
Right.
Sure, Jagger's
and
a local spook store.
He was saying
the scratch
if you couldn't
comes
hear what he was saying
when
he was talking.
Childish
Barry was saying that
anyway,
Thomas Zane died in
I'm
the cabin
just getting to the best part.
When the island
All
exploded.
Of the articles about this stuff were written
and then his
by
girlfriend
Cynthia
died.
Weaver. I asked around, and she's that crazy
And all of these
lady
articles
lady.
That Barry found were
what?
Written by
the
Cynthia
lady?
Weaver, which was
she
that crazy
loopy,
little
but she's not
lady, you know, like, oh, don't go in the light.
Anyway, she
it'll kill you.
Jagger and Zane
or sorry, don't go in the darkness. It'll kill you. You gotta stay in the light.
Kind of a breakdown.
Which is useful advice in these, you know, dark, dark times. Okay, we're here, Barry. Randall, you can go. We got some business with Rose. Oh, there's a hole in her floorboards? Whoa, man, I need to get that, cleaned. Need to get that fixed.
Welcome to oh dear.
Mr. Oh, her face.
I'm
her face.
I'm so glad you're here.
Oh, Barry, why are we going in here?
Oh.
Am I the only one who saw that? Her face, fucking.
Yes. Please come in.
Oh no. Oh no.
Hey. This is really good.
I'm sure it is, Barry. I'm sure it is.
Rose.
Yes.
My manuscript. I really need it.
I understand. I know what you need. A muse to inspire you.
Oh, for Barry.
Now, I wonder if that line was
she
Rose.
Have anything. Yeah.
Yeah. Or if that was...
Oh, what's... Oh.
That was the darkness.
Barry! What?
Or a bit of both.
It's coming for you, hiding in my barber's skin. I'm too weak to stop it. You must turn the lights on.
Better get out of there, Alan. Better get out of there.
You must finish what you started. I insist.
Shit's getting crazy, man.
Turn the light on.
Back to work, boy.
I think that would be the most terrifying part of that experience. You know, like, yo, you're having a trippy dream. You just got knocked out by, like, you know... A nice fan who you now may think is crazy.
Hungover. Only
but then you see
going.
That? Back to work, boy.
Can't tell reality,
just to like,
dream
just to like, nail in the fact that you're either slowly going crazy.
She's an old woman in a funeral dress.
Well, shit in the world is going very wrong.
She's very strict. I'm writing faster and faster. My manuscript is being heavily revised. The edits are getting very aggressive, and each day there's less of me and more of her. I hate it, but I know she's right. She promises me I can save Alice this way. She knows more of this than I do. About the complex incantation I'm attempting. About
incantation.
This place. She's worked with another writer under similar circumstances. Thomas.
That's an interesting thing to say
the story seems
about
to be
your,
shifting.
You know,
it's turning into a horror
it's
story.
An incantation.
I'm getting close. I can feel it.
Obviously, the Alan in the TV knew a lot more than the Alan now.
Rose took a day for me. I had less than 12 hours left to meet the kidnapper.
Right. The kidnapper,
all
I've forgotten.
Get Barry into the car, work something out once I got on the road.
Oh, Rose.
Barry was out of it. He was way too heavy to carry.
Oh, Barry.
You're right. I deserve more money.
Yeah, I'm not carrying him.
So handsome.
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diner.
And Rose.
What can I get you today? Coffee?
I couldn't work up much hate for Rose. Something had used her to get to me, and left its mark.
First refill is free. Milk and sugar on the counter there. Wouldn't
she's
you
just
like to
the
hear
shell of
specials?
Her former self.
Thank you. A nice day. Come back.
Well, I'm getting the shit out of here.
Flashlight were gone.
Getting the poop out
I have to find a way to get Barry into the car.
Oh, wait,
as quickly.
Let's read this page. Randolph calls the police.
Mr. Randolph liked Rose. That little smile she had. How she was still sweet when life had tried so hard to make her bitter. It wasn't any of his business what she did in her trailer. But those strangers, the writer and his smart-ass sidekick, looked like trouble. And they'd been in there for hours, way past her normal bedtime. He reached for the phone and called the sheriff's station.
Oh, Randolph!
Possible. There was no time to
it's
waste.
It's like... As if I'm, like, not being punished for just, you know, trying to find information. You know, I got fucking knocked out. And then... The guy, you know, the trailer park supervisor calls the police. So it's like, as soon as I wake up, I'm fucked anyways. What?! God, Alan, shit's getting crazy. You need to... I would just be like, okay, I'm driving out of town right now. I give up.
The weather's getting heavy.
Although, I'd have to find
this
my wife.
Especially glad I'm here talking to you and not home in bed. Once the weather takes a turn like this, I can't sleep at all. It's all tangled bed sheets and
dark thoughts.
Punctuated by the occasional plunge into nightmare. Is it just me? Well, perhaps it is. But I hope I can make the night a little bit easier to get through. Caller, you're on KBF FM.
Okay, I'm getting the shit out of here. Oh, wait, we gotta go this way. It's that way on the left is blocked.
The way you are, but, well, I can't sleep either, you know?
Actually, I'm gonna listen to this. I forgot this was a really trippy radio. Radio broadcast.
Well, you sound like a man with a problem.
I never understood what this guy's talking about. It might just be because he's changing.
I had a, argument with Danny. You know, Danny, and,
with the law, you know, and I'm just, well...
I heard something like that, Walt.
Yeah, well, you know, he's, you know, Daddy's my best friend, and, they let me bail today, and now I'm just alone here at the window, you know, waiting, man.
He's just tripping out. He's just tripping out.
I was just outside looking up at the sky above our broadcast tower thinking the same thing. What are you waiting for, Walt?
What are you waiting for, Walt?
I don't know. You know, something's gonna happen. You know?
Something's gonna happen.
I think I better go.
Well, maybe I think we're gonna go make something happen.
Well,
you hang in there, Walt.
You, Walt, hang in there.
You hang in there.
Take a little break, folks. This weather's really...
Okay. We have an adventure of our own to continue. Or, well, if, you know, getting attacked by the police is an adventure.
Because
there's a lot of police here. Why'd they bring the whole police force?
God knows what you've done to that poor girl.
You know?
This is Agent Nightingale, FBI.
The FBI agent.
You're under arrest.
He's like, oh, I'll just bring everyone.
Muscle, I'll unload right in your goddamn face. Stay right where you are.
Now shades. Something to note is that we totally did not ship those civilians standing right there. I mean, Alan Wake's still, obviously.
What are? I'm standing right here, you goddamn maniac.
But Nightingale just unloading. You're not even a thought if you had hit that
other. I hated to
leave
Barry behind.
Totally ready
to
sacrifice.
I missed my appointment with the kidnapper.
Oh, right. Gotta run. Can't postulate while being chased. This way? This way. Because you can tell there's like a path, sort of. So, this part, are they behind me? Are they right behind me? Okay, let's run. Okay, then left. Left, please run. Gotcha. Getting the fuck out of here. Oh no. Why do you stop right there? Why would you stop right on the bridge? Not cool, man. Not cool. Okay, wait. I think I'm good. I don't think they see me. I think we can see. No. Ooh, almost saw me.
Oh, damn.
Okay, wait. No, we got this. No! I'm almost out. Okay. They're stupid. And Alan is slow. Alan is slow as fuck. Like, how did they not know that I just got past them? Okay. Getting the fuck out of there. Oh, man. Okay. I think we dodged him. It's getting foggy, though. It's getting very foggy up in here. I don't like it.
Come on, guys! We need to head him off!
Let's see what this is. Dark presence sleeps.
For decades,
oh, no.
The darkness that wore Barbara Jagger's skin slept fitfully in the dark place that was its home and prison. It was hungry and in pain. It dreamed of its nights of glory when the poet's writing had called it from the depths and given it a brief, terrible taste of power and freedom. The rock stars had stirred it from the deep sleep the poet had sunk it back to in the end. When it sensed the rider on the ferry, it opened its eyes.
Okay, so that's how powerful a being this is. It's been asleep while the wind's picking up. Oh no. I sense the dark presence. It's coming. It's coming for me. Yeah, this is such a powerful... Okay, yeah, back to my thought. This is such a powerful being that it's just been asleep. It's just been asleep this whole time. But now that Alan's here, it's awake. It's awake.
Come in, Agent Nightingale. This is Sheriff Breaker.
Oh, no.
Nightingale, over. What on earth?
Also, somehow, beyond all odds, I'm back in the fucking forest. God damn it. How does that keep happening to Alan Wake? Like, I understand, you know, like, this story is evolving into its own story, because I'm finding pages of what's going on. But, like, Jesus, how You were just with Barry a second ago. I mean, I understand we're in the middle of a forest, basically, you know, like a forest town way out on the countryside. But Jesus Christ, Alan. Don't drink the coffee next time. At least we got a light. Now. Well, that's the cops. I guess we've got away from them. Because they can't see me from all the way up there. I mean, I can't see them. But the presence can see them. Oh, no. Oh, no! They're gone. And I'm just gonna watch? That's brutal. You guys were shooting me a second ago? Now you're dead. And they're dead. It's like they were never there.
This horror was good. Everywhere I went, circling me. The cops didn't stand a chance. They were after a writer, not a monster.
But it's interesting Nightingale was like, hey, I'm bringing backup, you know? I'm gonna fucking need it. Gonna fucking need some backup. Oh, I could just jump right into the horror, huh? Yeah, no, thank you. Oh, the light went out. Well, fuck you. I don't have any weapons. I don't even have a goddamn flashlight. It's not good. It's not good. Opposite of good. Wow, this car got flung. It's Wake's doing. Yeah, that makes sense. I guess, though, if Wake wrote the story, it is his doing, though, technically? Kind of a roundabout thing that happened. Oh no. I hear chopper blades. Oh no! Away from the chopper! Okay. Use the rocks as cover. And we be Gucci. If you run along the edge of the cliff, you make yourself a target. You want to run amongst the rocks. That doesn't matter now. That copter is what? Because, you know, like a normal copter, normal police helicopter could probably run away from some birds, you know? But, like, those are fucking dark birds. Those crash into your ship and they're just gonna keep crashing into it. You know, they don't get hurt by metal. And then they're gone. Great. Is that Stuckey's? That kind of gives me some relation as to where I am. Is there anything here? Oh, there's a radio! But there's no... There's no... Like, mic. It's a one-way radio. Damn it. There's not even any food! That's where it's the most. Nah, I don't care about the police officers. Sorry, everyone. Oh, they got Wheeler and Rose? Wait, what? Oh, that's great. Nightingale was just fucking drunk when he was just, you know, unloading shots into me. No wonder he didn't give a shit if he hit this civilian. Anyway, Doc in, take a look at both. Over. Gotcha. Okay. On my way. On my way. On the way. Okay, now if I can just get a goddamn flashlight, that would be great. That would be the best.
I imagine that the broadcast tower in the distance was part of the local radio station.
What am I looking at?
Maine seemed like a decent guy. Perhaps he could give me directions to the coal mine.
Is it because it's over that ridge? Oh, the darkness is following me. That's just great. can't just take a lovely stroll through the woods without waiting for, you know, the darkness to just pop out and just be like, hey, fuck you.
I wouldn't get through without a light.
Okay. But I got this. I know how to work mechanics and shit on bits of old engines, I guess. Or just, you know, yanker cord. Same thing, really. Okay, power! Now, let's see what we can do with a bit of light. Which would be useful if there were, like, a horde of enemies. But not... I mean, it works for a gate. It gets the job done. You know, and it fizzes out. Doesn't provide me any defense whatsoever. Oh, I'm screwed. At least I'm not playing on Nightmare difficulty. Unless I am. I might be playing on Nightmare difficulty. Oh no. Oh no. Don't remember, actually. That's the best part. That's the best part. Oh, what was that? You guys heard that, right? Oh, okay, it was that. Hey. Hey, hey, no, I already see you guys, man. Don't need to, like, wiggle, you know, to get my attention. I see you just fine. You don't need to... Hey, stop me wiggling. Okay. I warned you. Take my light attack. Time set. Time set. Yeah. Suck it, Gates. I told you not to wiggle. You don't need to wiggle to get my attention. I see you for
it took me a moment to recognize the flashbang grenades.
I threw it away!
An ideal weapon for my situation.
Okay, so I have a bunch of flashbangs. Well, 6 flashbangs. And a flashlight, that's great. I can get some I can get the job done, but once I jump down, it's just gonna be a run. Just as soon as I see the guys, just book it. Because I could fight them, but I only have 6 flashbangs. Those are for emergencies! Emergencies! Oh, I want emergencies! Running, 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 running! Suck it! Zombie dudes! I see a light! I see a light! I see a light! Oh! Okay, and run! Oh, there's a third dude! Not cool, not cool. Okay. I will use the light if I can just get close. There's more! There's more! Yeah, into the light! Into the light! Into the light! Ooh! Ooh, didn't waste the signal flashbang. But cried like a little baby. Ooh, what was that? There was like 10? I want to say there was at least 10 of those guys, because there were the 3. Oh, wait, shit, there's supplies. Supplies. Okay, good, 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 good. Good, 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 good. Okay. Just take a moment to breathe. Oh, yeah. I want, okay, yeah, there were 3, and then, like, 2-3 more popped out, and then I want to say 2 from the left came in, right as I was getting close. I'm not sure. Okay, let's just listen to some soothing radio.
And here's another call. You're
maybe lure them into the light. You guys have seen me try it in the past.
It's Milt Peabody, Pat. What's on your mind, Milt?
Milt.
Well, I live near the trailer park, Pat, and there's a big ruckus.
Yeah, big ruckus. You mean fucking gunfire?
From me too. What's going on, do you know?
Because that's more than a ruckus, man. That's a shootout.
Police cars there, lots of sirens.
You know, like, shit could be going down.
Buzzing around, and I think I heard some gunshots.
Okay.
Gunshots?
As soon as I... Wait,
yes,
is stuff glowing
like
over there?
Pistol.
I thought I was supposed to spark. Oh, yeah, anyways, as soon as I go over the bridge, I'm just going to get molested. Because there's only one way out on both sides. You know, it's not like these wired areas where I was just able to kind of run around like an idiot. Until I saw light and I was like, LIGHT! You know?
I'm certainly going to give the station a call, Milt. Okay.
Who do you think was shooting everyone?
Okay, thanks.
Well, I guess they don't know. I'm sure everyone at the trailer park fucking did that. Okay, I'm ready. Gonna get attacked on the bridge. Gonna get attacked on the bridge. Gonna get fucking get. Oh, I need to get attacked. Oh, sorry. I got attacked right as I got off the bridge from every single side. Running! You guys suck. All you guys? Yeah, you all suck. That's how you do it. You trash talk. fucking shoot your lantern in their face. Trash talk, trash talk, trash talk. Trash talk! And running. Okay. Don't anyone come from behind you, man! Okay, and running. It's too late! Alright, it's almost close to dead. Okay, everyone die! Yes! Triple kill! What? There's more? There's more on my way? Okay. Kill three. I think I got them all. Okay, I gotta book it. I gotta keep going. I gotta keep going. There's no light. I'm not safe here. Not safe here, not safe here, not safe here. I see some light in the distance, but that could be anything. Okay, wait, I see. Okay, I think we're good. If we can just get past these douchers, doucheries, douchebaggeries, oh, running leap attack, jump. Amazing. Jump attack. I see light, that's it! Stay away from me, bastards.
Stay away! I'm the magic and jumping man, who also writes books.
Suck it.
I hope Maine could lend me a car to get to the coal mine.
This gate is a present to you. Inscribed on it are the letters FU. Well, I'll say it once and I'll say it again. I made it, even though I cried like a sissy baby. But hey, I have a ton of flashbangs and full stock, well, not full stock, but almost half full stock flashlight, you know? That's pretty good. If I could only get a fucking gun. Well, this lady sounds like a douchebag.
Thank you very much for that compassionate viewpoint.
Compassionate.
Oh, here's a little surprise. The famous writer Alan Wake just walked in.
Alan Wake.
I'm gonna see if I can talk him into an interview.
With looking very grim and dirty.
Come on in, Mr. Wake.
Sure, sure.
Oh, I'm so glad you could find the time.
Also, I brought the police. Just so you know.
Nowhere to run now, Dan Brown. You back away from me.
Now, how did...
Whoa.
Question is, how did Nightingale know where I was?
Right here, right?
Cool your jets, Nightingale.
Cool your jets, man. Oh, my God.
Dude,
it's been so long.
What the hell's the
success.
Matter with you? There's a civilian in there.
Yeah, but how did Nightingale know where I was? Because I was just fucking romping through the woods, trying to just survive, you know? I mean, maybe it was the next logical place, but they got there at the same time as me.
It was ridiculous.
Which means it took them that long to drive there.
It was probably good.
As the time it took me to
tell Maine where I was going.
Which I don't even know how long it's been, but I want to say it's been at least a good 30 minutes here, you know? We're a good third of the way through this episode. Maybe I'm totally wrong. Actually, no, we're kind of in the beginning. I don't know. I want to say a third. I want to say a third at that point. After that cutscene. Oh no. Oh no, oh no, oh no. Oh no, 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 no. Okay. You guys suck. You guys suck. You guys suck. You guys suck. And Flair? Only one? Okay, just do this quickly. Do this quickly. Come on. And Shkabersh. And we Gucci. Oh yeah, give me the light. Oh yes, the revolver. Oh. Now that we have the revolver, we are officially in badass. Because not only, it's not just a revolver. It's a revolver plus 10 flashbangs. That's, and 3 torches. I thought it was one. I'm glad I guess I didn't look because I thought it was one. And if I had known it was 3, I would have wasted one. But now we have 3 right off the bat. Yeah, so, it's not just a revolver, it's a revolver, 10 flashbangs, and 3 whatevers. 3 flares. I wish I had a little bit more batteries, but I'll take what I can get. Okay, be on my way. Okay, so, we're gonna go up this way, because even though the right way is on the left, this is stuff. And I'm pretty sure I'm playing Nightmare difficulty, so I want stuff. You know? Whatever helps me get through the night.
Long, dark night. Winter is coming. No.
An amazing show, though. Ah, jeez. If you don't know, I'm referencing Game of Thrones. Okay. I forgot how long of a walk up this thing was. Giant mountain. I have to get up right there, is where the stuff is. But there's a page, so it'll all be worth it. After we go up this entire huge mountain. This is also very well sculpted, you know, like a perfect staircase. Naturally up to the thing. I wonder if people did that. No, I'm sorry, guys. Tickle in my throat. If, people made the staircase, you know, like carved it out of the mountain. Or if that was already there. And they just sort of put their antenna up there. Radio tower. Almost there! Water! Actually, you know, I'm gonna go get some water in a second. Because my throat is seriously dry and I would like some water. Water sounds good right now, for the voice. And especially since the episodes are long, you know? Like, the Alan Wake episodes are, like, sometimes an hour and a half long. Usually an hour, but, you know. It's give or take, half an hour or so. Usually an hour. Okay, we got the stuff, so. If I recall, we're pretty well safe up here. Five? Okay, I can take five torches. Sorry, not torches. I've been playing some Minecraft. I want to do an episode of that, too. Anyways, I have five. I'm just going to pause it. Sorry, this is totally unprofessional. I'll be back 2 minutes. Not even. And I'm back. I'm sorry, that was... I'll just edit it out, you know, it'll be instantaneous. And the whatever. It'll be like, I was here and then I wasn't, you know? It'll be 2 seconds. Okay, anyways, where were we? Let's read this page. Walter fights Dan.
Danny had stepped out, but what stumbled back in was something else. Something alien. A monster. Walter tried to kill it. First with his fists, then a chair. It wouldn't die. Instead, it kept coming, unaffected by the beating it had taken. After Walter managed to kick it down the cellar stairs, fear took over. He ran, got behind the wheel, gunned the engine. The booze wouldn't make him forget, but he knew he had to try.
So he said his friend was an alien. Or, well, we know what really happened. He was taken, filled with the darkness. But it seems like it took his friend another day to fully turn, so maybe it was, you know... It seems some people... can just be taken by the darkness instantaneously, you know, just completely changed or destroyed the moment, you know. But some people, it takes a little bit, like an infection that wears you down. Like, what is it? Stucky. Which is why, maybe that's why you have stronger taken. The stronger taken are strong imprints of what's left, which is why they, like, stutter sentences of... you know, what's left of them, you know. Because it says it's just the dead twitchings of, you know, those, when they say those random sentences, that's just like the skin deep, you know, version of what's left of them, of the taken. So. Just lost my train of thought, damn it. Oh yeah, so maybe the reason some taken are deliberately stronger than others is their will that is destroyed by the darkness, you know, and that strong will that's left, you know, is what's created. Which is why some are stronger, some are just, you know, just big anyways. You know, that's why they're tough, some are smaller. then some are small, but like have, you know, extremely strong legs. At least that's my theory. As the darkness could just be fucking pounds, I am staggered. You know. Like these birds! Like these fucking birds. Yeah, no. No. No, thank you. I'm good. I don't need birds in my life. No, thank you. They will peck my eyes out. Okay. Back to the main objective, now that we have some flares. It's got 5 flares and 10 flashbangs. We're looking good. Wish I had more batteries, I'll say again. But we'll find some more, you know. Oh, come on! I was just hanging out. I knew I was gonna get attacked soon, but not this soon.
First. No, you first.
No, you first! Dead. 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 Yeah, this is Nightmare. Only in Nightmare would you need 4 bullets to kill an enemy.
Dead. Headshots!
Oh no. Run out of bullets. Okay, so I'll have to use a flashbang in the next fight. We'll have to round up a few guys and— Oh wait, no, I've seen a generator, so let's definitely activate that first. Oh wait, not a generator.
There was no sensible reason for the power company work lights to be here. It was almost as if they'd been left for someone like me to use.
Almost as if it was me they left it for. Okay. Yes, ammo. And another flashbang. Okay, I will definitely have to use a flashbang in the next fight. I also see a thingy-thing in here. The darkness controls the taking. Well, I knew that, but what's the— Do you guys see? It almost looks like there's handprints in the paint at the bottom of the words. Like, I don't know, like smudges. I don't know how to describe it. Shotgun, yes, thank you.
Oh no.
I count 5. 5, everyone? Oh shit. No, sorry, not 5. 4. 3. Oh no, okay. No. There we go. Only one more. Come on. One, two. Ah, shit. It's only a double bucket. Ah, pop! Ah! Playing it close to the chest, Rally.
I like it.
Okay, so now we're looking great. We don't have a lot of everything, but we have a little bit of everything. And, you know, it's always better, I think, to be good at everything than better at one thing. You know, just have, like, a shit ton of ammo and one gun. Just have a little bit of everything, and we'll be chilled. Now, if we could only get some other, like, a heavy weapon, you know? Got semi-heavy weapon, but not super heavy.
The bulldozers.
Oh, a bulldozer!
Mud and rocks.
It's a bulldozer getting out of the woods!
It crashed the concrete wall and landed heavily in the yard. If it were an animal, it would have shaken its head after the impact, fixed its eyes on me, and charged. Of course, it had no head, nor eyes. Shadows crawled on its form, twisting into a monster. Then, it came for me.
It came for me. The tract came. All over me.
That sounds creepy. Now, where are we going? Okay, so we just killed those douchebags. There were a bunch of lights I could use, but whatever, you know. I kicked ass regardless. What else? Is there stuff in here? I see goodies. Batteries? Revolver ammo, nice. And batteries. Okay, now we're really looking good. I'll just have to conserve my shotgun, because I have plenty of this ammo now. They'll be coming for me shortly. Wait, I saw something. What just mean? I thought it was shiny for a second. I'm just going bonko crazy in the woods! Lovely. Another page to disrupt this nightmare of windy trees.
Sarah trusted her gut, And her gut said Agent Nightingale was an asshole. He felt wrong. And it wasn't just the smell of stale booze.
He felt wrong?
It was in the way he flashed his badge, pulled rank, the look in his eyes when he wanted answers. Where was Alan Wake? What was this about an accident? Where was his wife? And most importantly, why did she let Wake go?
So many questions!
He wouldn't answer her questions. Federal business was all he'd say.
Federal business. Yeah, because that's really useful, you know? Okay, so we got some temporary relief from the craziness in the woods. More ammo! And shotgun shit! I'm just kind of surprised, like, who leaves shotgun ammo in a box? Like, maybe revolver ammo? For, like, I don't know, like, you know, game wardens or something? I don't know, like, just self-protection. But, I don't know, shotgun ammo? I don't know. But, hey, I am chilling now. You guys thought I thought I was Hello? Chilling before? You guys thought I was chilling before?
Alice?
It's Alice!
Oh shit!
Alan, I'm so afraid. Keep me in the dark.
Calls from my wife who's trapped in the darkness.
I look at you, Alan, and it's not you. Something else. Looking out from behind your eyes.
Alice, I'm here!
I'm so alone here. It's all gonna go to hell. You need to be careful.
Okay, that made no sense at all.
The connection had been terrible.
100% no sense.
Thing that hadn't been right with the call.
She sounded I remember this way.
But she had
There's
called
cool
me.
Stuff this way. Also, a shit ton of guys. But, stuff. See? And stuff is always worth the fight. You gotta fight for your right to have stuff. You know? See? Stuff... So much stuff, I don't even know what to do with all the stuff. Okay. Get ready for a fight. Bye. No, okay. Was that it? Really? No fight? Really? Oh. Okay. Uh-oh. Sure, I'll take that. I thought I was going to have to fight someone. I distinctly remember having to fight someone before. Huh. That's really odd. Okay. I was wrong.
Wrenched itself loose from the steel framework. Wrapped in darkness,
oh, it floated. Shit. Now even twitching. Objects are attacking out. I mean, we knew cars were and
the heavy
other things.
At me with
giant machinery,
force.
But like.
I threw myself out of the way.
Just random just bits and pieces of shit. Oh,
I turned
boy.
My flashlight.
It's over. It's like
it
you sit on a chair. The chair attacks you. Flew at me again. You know? Turn on your computer. The computer attacks you. Try to get a soda at the soda machine, and the soda machine just fucking attacks you. What kind of
I could see a railway bridge up ahead, and a warehouse of some sort on the opposite side.
I'm sorry, like, what? Yeah,
I
what
hoped I could find a car
crazy shit is Alan dealing with these days? Follow? Okay. You've always done me right. Crazy, weird yellow signs that are eerily painted and kind of look like blood a little bit. But you've always done me well, you know? I mean, hey, that last one we saw didn't even hurt us. We just got cool ammo. I totally thought we were gonna have to fight someone, you know? The train! Oh, sorry, guys. My throat today. That's why I got something to drink. Oh, no, you get away from me! Oh, you're blocking the path. Just get out of the way. Gosh.
The darkness
oh, that's great. Because that's what those things usually do. You know,
everything in its path.
Walk across them and they just bend out of shape. And... Yeah. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Okay. Oh shit. Inanimate object fight. I got this. Okay. Of course. What? I threw it too far. Actually, no. Perfect. Give some words. Oh, shit. Okay, that one's dead. Okay, I need to move. Get behind this thing. Ah, shit. Kill it.
I got. Okay. Kill it. Shit. Okay. One more thing. Oh no, I think that thing died. Okay. One more. Yeah, these things. And that thing. But that thing's behind me. Yeah. So let's see if I can't kill it before I destroy those gates. Just wait for it to drop. Yeah. And there we go. Now we can destroy the gates. There's one. And these ones aren't even flying at me. They're just twitching. It's just twitching. Ooh. Twitch no more! Sorry, that was terrifying. Oh, come on! I killed your twitchy friends. Why can't you guys... Oh, shit, okay. They killed themselves. So if it goes over the edge, it just pops? No, thank you. I don't want your barrel. Get away from me. Oh, I could've just popped this? Killed them? Okay. I'll use one of those later. You guys will see how cool they are. And useful. If you see though, if you guys are playing this and you see those around, just bucket shoot them if they're enemies. Make sure enemies are close. You'll see what happens. Or you'll see what happens in a second.
As a teenager, just starting to get interested in writing, Stephen King had been a source of inspiration to me. I thought about all the inanimate objects that had come to life in his books. No one is safe in a good horror story. Certainly not the protagonist.
Yeah, you said that.
That's
much.
What makes them fun.
Oh, almost this forgot the heavy-duty flashlight.
The darkness.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Okay, I sense the dark presence. This is perfect battle area. See, there's a bunch of these things. That screams fight. And thermos. I don't know if I got this last time, actually.
Hey, I found a thermos. Cool. Awesome. Everything is cool when you're part of a team.
Okay. This button? This button. Okay. Let's see. Okay. Stop. Give me the moment. Come on. Yep. Oh, come on. Okay. There we go. Yeah, there we go. It's like a light bulb. It's like a flash bomb. Oh, yeah. Perfect way to save your ammo. And now my ammo's back! Booyah! Yeah, I'm just gonna use my shotgun now. Like, I have so much ammo. Fuck it, let's just use my shotgun. Oh, an enemy? A big enemy? Oh, well, I'm just gonna fucking shoot him in the face with my shotgun. Oh, shit! Okay, I didn't see that. No, okay! Not cool. Okay, fuck it. Just use one of those. Ooh. Okay. I underestimated that situation. I forgot that guy came from the left. I got really cocky. And I'm gonna keep using the shotgun. Oh, yeah. Okay, if I recall, there's some items here. In the light, you can hurt them. Yes, I know that. I think there's some items in here. Let's see if we can't find them. There's a boss fight down there. Okay, so we're full up on ammo on that. Oh wait, let's watch this. Before we do the boss fight, we'll go to Nightstrings. I love these anyways. A thin veneer of desperate self-delusion, covering a vast cosmos of madness and horror. Let me see if I can't get a better shot. Like I tried for the other videos. No, I don't think I can move the TV either. Put it right there.
Journalist Alvin Derlis' trip to study the local customs of an insular community in Night Springs has been less than successful. Until tonight.
Well, I'm glad you changed your minds about this. Ancient customs, local mythology. My editor loves this kind of stuff.
Well, Mr. Derlis, you don't want to feel like we're on exhibition. But you have demonstrated the seriousness of your intent.
Oh, I am serious. Really, just do your thing. I'll stay out of your way and observe.
Actually, I thought you could assist us. I'm afraid we are a man short. It would provide you with an intimate perspective.
Could I really?
Of course, Mr. Derlis.
I guess that's the least.
Derlis.
What would I have to do?
To do?
Here, let me show you with a kiss.
I
Get some dead.
What did you add?
No.
You have well pleased Nixie Perka, the dweller in flesh. Your body shall host his thousand young, and all shall be glory.
Which means that she, like, put something into his body field, making out, like, fucking it with her tongue, or ugh.
Alvin Derlett learned a harsh lesson. If you go looking for mythology, it may come looking for you. And such quests always bear fruit. In night springs.
Okay, now we get to go fight a boss fight. That's fun. Oh wait, there's his face. Okay, one more thing. Attacked by the
darkness. Darkness surged towards me, sucking everything loose from the ground into its depths, tugging at my clothes. I saw the flare the kidnapper had dropped and threw myself towards it just as I felt my feet leave the ground. The darkness embraced me with the force of a tornado. Somehow I managed to light the flare. The darkness roared and cast me away. I fell toward the dark waters of the lake far below.
Okay. Are you ready? Ouch. My feet. Bring it, bitch! Bring it! I have so much ammo! Oh my god! Oh, running. Running. Okay, dealing with you fuckers first. I'm already dead? It's because I wasn't paying attention to the boss fight. Well, to the boss specifically. I need to just be chucking fucking, you know, like grenades. Flash grenades. Okay. Just flash grenade? Okay. No, okay. Did it hit him? I'm not sure it hit him. I want to say it did, but I'm not sure it did. Okay, while he's fucking stuck, just chuck another tires. Oh yeah! Chuck another one. Oh, they just fucking explode on contact with him. Gotcha. I need to stay close as to hit him. You see? Because he can only turn so well. Oh yeah! I'm amazing. And now you just can take off the, you know, the survivors. Just peg them off. And I don't care about ammo because there's fucking these things everywhere. And that was why you keep the flashbangs. And now I can just fucking load up on torches. Sorry, I keep saying torches. I've been playing Minecraft lately. I can just load up on fucking, flares, and we can just save the flashbangs for, like, something really dire. That's why I didn't just fucking, like, throw a flashbang every time I saw an enemy when that was presentable, you know? I thought about it. I strategized with my brainicle. Yeah, I just called it the brainicle. Trademark. Brainicle. And now we're just good on goods. It's awesome. I love having plenty of supplies. So that way, the next episode, I can groan about it when I have none. Ah, game. When I have supplies, I can take the enemies out. When I don't have supplies,
I had a couple of hours.
I can't take the enemies out, you know? Oh, at least the sun came up. At least the fucking sun came up.
The coal mine wasn't far now.
Okay, we're almost to Lover's Peak. Or sorry, not Lover's Peak, right, the coal mine, where the next meeting spot was to be arranged.
Today,
I don't have any of my weapons! Or maybe I'm just,
because
the daytime,
any other
maybe they're all in the car,
a drowning man will clutch
in strong. My giant pockets that I talked about, the giant pockets little, that we went to the store with Barry to get to.
The story of the manuscript was coming true. The current of its narrative had taken me deeper and deeper into dark waters.
Right.
Alice had been taken from
blocked
me.
Off.
Barry was probably in jail. I was a fugitive from the FBI. The whole world taken over by the dark.
I don't know. I kind of like that car better.
It all felt real.
but it matches the textbook case. I don't like trucks very much. Trucks are all right. They're good and dandy. I don't know. I kind of like this boat better though. We'll swap cars, random dude. I hope. Yeah, I did. I am stealing someone's car, aren't I? I'm a fugitive. I can do what I want. I'm a fugitive from the government. My wife's dead. Shadowy creatures are following me. Fuck, we'll steal the car. Seriously, though, what is Alan thinking? Oh, wait, is that a page? Is that a page? Am I just going crazy? Am I just losing it? I'm just losing it. Going bonkers crazy. Okay, let's drive up a path in my new car! It's a nice car, isn't it? I like it. I like it. It's only had minor damage when I kind of... Okay, a little bit more minor damage. But, you know, it's all good. It's all good. Oh, shit. No, I can take it. It can take it. It's a beast, you know. It could take the blows. Go up the hill! Go up the hill! Why won't you go up the hill? No, I'm not changing. I like this car. She's got a little kinks, but, you know... She's beautiful. She's beautiful on the inside. She's got nice seats. They're comfy. Even if the suspension is kind of, like, broken now. You know, the whole underside of the car is just dead. Is dead, basically. But it's all Gucci in the hoochie. It's all Gucci. Okay. I could go out here or take this car. But I like this car. I'm sticking with it. I'm sticking with this car. I like it. But there's a radio transmission up there. I'm just interested in getting the next part. There's a page in that area. I'm going to the next part. Just on my way. I'm just driving. I'm just driving, you know? Just continuing on my way. And we're here.
I was early. I was supposed to meet the kidnapper.
Oh, I'm early? Oh, we could have gone back, I guess.
The coal mine was quiet. Whatever. It was a museum now.
Abandoned coal mine. These situations just keep getting... Oh, page. Just keep getting better and better, you know? Forest, and then fucking getting drugged, and... Fucking... Then there were the birds. When we dropped out of that cage. Like that sky... That sky bridge or whatever. Ugh. It's not even what it's called. Now, the story just keeps getting worse, man. You gotta get out of here! But he's sticking to his guns. Saving his wife. Or doing what he can, you know, to think. Try to save his wife.
I didn't want to go outside.
He doesn't really know what's going on, so.
Cops had to be looking for me.
Even though I totally stole
the
his
new
car,
sun
I
turned the place into a sauna. The day dragged on. Different scenarios ran through my mind. Ways of how I'd torture the kidnapper to get Alice back. Or the different horrible things he could have done to her. I imagined
as
her dead. I had no way of knowing she was still alive. It was killing me.
As the sun starts to set.
I was running on blind hope. It was all a waste of time.
No one came.
The bastard never showed up.
That's brutal as fuck. I'm sorry, Alan.
Wake! Where the hell are you?
This guy have all my ammo?
You know where Mirror
my fucking 14 flares, full up battery and and revolver and probably shotgun.
See your wife alive, cause if you do, you better watch what you say to me. Do we understand each other?
I wanna talk
give
to
me,
Alice.
Give me,
I want the manuscript. Don't keep me waiting, Wake.
Well, okay.
Whoa.
Fucking breaks up our date, you know, doesn't meet us at the coal mine, and then calls and is like, oh, come to this new place, in the dark, because he'll probably make it. Good thing I have a fucking that asshole.
It was close.
23, damn, okay.
Ever before.
I'm gonna keep saving it for now, until I have full. Once I have full shotgun, I promise you, I'll just fucking take that thing out, and I'll just start wreaking havoc. For now, we'll just keep it chill, you know, with the 42 shots of revolver ammo, you know. Oh, shit, okay, well, double fall. Double fall never hurt anybody, you know. Okay, well, we're just gonna... Oh, Sarah in the radio station.
With Nightingale gone and the night wind blowing in through the broken studio window, Maine stared at Sarah. The sheriff looked away. Maine's voice shook with barely controlled anger. That boy's do.
Okay, sorry, I just wanted to see what that was for a second. Just wanted to see Thomas and
when Thomas Zane fell for Barbara Jagger, it happened fast. She was young, vibrant, and beautiful, full of life. He had never been a very happy man, and without any seeming effort, she had changed all that. Zane felt good for the first time in his life. Everything she did was another piece of a jigsaw puzzle he hadn't even known he'd been missing. And best of all, she
he's
made the
enchanted
words flow,
by her.
Strong and sharp. She was his muse.
His muse. Interesting wording. Oh, infinite ammo? I love infinite ammo. What? Yeah, because I totally missed the revolver the first time they gave me that. Totally missed it the first time. They're just giving me so much goddamn ammo. Boop. 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 Oh, they both missed. Oh, it's not good. That's not good. I got this, go. I got this. Take it. Batteries, batteries, batteries. Don't fail me, don't fail me. Batteries, okay. Bam, bam, bam. Bam, 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 bam. Okay, that looked like 8. That might have been 7. But I can just fucking watch this right now, because I can just... Get more! Ah, shit. Okay. No! No double-axing action for you guys. No, thank you. It probably could have been more... Good thing I'm over here. I probably could have been more conservative on my flashlight batteries, but whatever. Ah, fuck you. And you're dead. And you're dead. No, 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 no. No, thank you. I will not have any today. I'm not interested when you're sailing, giant dark gear. I will be fine. With just the ammo I have on me, thank you. Oh man. Flashbangs! Nice. So now we have 5. 5 and 15. Okay, we're good. As far as ammo goes. Getting the shotgun out. As soon as they're rushing, come on, I'm waiting. Come on, that's why, yeah, okay. And they thought they had me cornered. That's so cute. Got a fucking shotgun, man. Double pump. Double pump. Okay. So if I recall, we can just open that, and then there's back in. Okay. Ah, oh, sorry, guys. My throat. Well, good thing we're safe. Well, I take a sip. Okay. Now, come on, Dark Speed. Yeah, thank you. Big splash. That just there's the more than one thing. Yeah. I was gonna say, kill it. Oh wait a minute. To the other side. Ah! Oh, shit. I usually kill them first. Well, okay. Oh, I'm in the face. Come on. Usually I kill those things before I jump in. I fell though. Okay, and now this fucking area.
What the hell?
Ah, shit. But that's... Oh, sorry. There's that darkness we heard about earlier. Oh, my car! It came back! Hey, buddy! Oh, you here to help me out in this troublesome time? You here to help me kill some fucking possessed motherfuckers? Well, I thank you for the assistance. It is much, much needed. Okay, now, what is the... Oh, no. No. Get back in the car. Get back in the fucking car. I'm just trying to figure out how to... Oh, there we go. Power. Bum. Turn on a dime, this baby can. Take you out. Ah! What? Ah, shit. taking out 2, 3, 4. Who wants some? Come on, come on, come on. I'll take you all. I'll take you all. I'll take you all. And fuck it, just go back and forth over his body. Oh, this car. We gotta name this baby. She came back to us. You know that saying. If you found her and... if you love her, if you love it, let it go. If it comes back, it's yours. If it doesn't, it never was. You know? And it came back to help us kill, help us fight. You understood. I'm gonna call you, I wanna say Old Faithful, but that's kind of redundant. Let's just call you Bill. Thanks, Bill. You helped us out. And you'll help us out again in 2 seconds. Sacrifice yourself, probably. Yeah, Bill doesn't know about that. Shh. That's between me and you. I'm gonna jump out of the car when the zombies are in closing in on me, because look, the light broke. But hey, Bill, hey, you know what? You know what? We're gonna make it through this, Bill. Oh shit, see? Ah! Okay! Bill, run! Bill, run! Bill, run! Bill, no! Okay, running! Ah! Shitty balls! Goodbye, Bill, I'm sorry, Bill! I wonder, if I shot it, could I, like, make it explode and kill them? Nah, I'm just running. You will live on in my heart, Bill! You will live on! In my heart. My heart is bleeding. It's literally bleeding. Oh, it's bleeding. Poor Bill. But we made it! Yay! Get some batteries. Okay, we Gucci. Or not. No, you will survive. The Bill! Bill. Okay, and torch? Sorry. You know why I'm thinking torch? Because it keeps the monsters away. Like in Minecraft. That's why I'm calling it torch. Oh man. Not just because I've been playing that recently, but quite literally it keeps the monsters away. Okay, die you motherfucker! Die you crazy motherfucker! That's one. Technically that's two. There we go. And then get the revolver ammo, and we'll be good. We'll be good. Oh, fuck. And we, look, our flare is just replenished. And we have full ammo again. Wow. Just wow. And you know what? We benefited from that fight because we actually fully replenished our, oh shit. What? I hear. I knew it! Shoot! Ah, it worked. I kept saying shoot him after I had already shot it. I just wanted it to explode because they were so close. I hear more. You guys heard that, right? You guys heard that, right? Fucking door opening, and then footsteps? Okay, we're getting up here immediately. Was it just me walking around? Oh, maybe I was freaking myself out. Oh, I swear to God I heard footsteps. Ooh, I'm getting chills. Yeah, it might just be me. Now, I wonder what's up with this chair. Because if you notice, it's bathed in red light. Like, there's light from the window, but barely. You know, this whole room is dark and gloomy, except for my flashlight. And then there's this. It almost seems to be giving off its own light. I wonder, like, if this has some kind of significance. Always made me wonder, but You know, it's all you. Some that's the last you see in that chair. Of their former selves.
But these were just the nerve twitches of a dead thing. Nothing.
Nerve twitches of a dead thing. I'm talking about filled with darkness.
In most cases, these puppets were enough for the purposes of the dark presence. But for anything more elaborate, as with the writer, it was different. It needed his mind. And so rather than taking him over completely, it merely touched him.
Okay. Good to know. Yeah, I was talking about that earlier, that those sentences they talk about, the dark things, well, the Taken, sorry, when the Taken say specific sentences, that's not, yeah, that's not the people, that's just what's left of the humans they used to be, you know, like, very topical bit of them. It was similar to what Rose was doing, you know, she was saying off her diner lines, you know. Rose is still, you know, Rose wasn't taken, but she was just touched in a very bad way. The worst way, probably.
There was no way the flashbang grenades were standard power company equipment.
Okay. We have so much goddamn ammo right now. I forgot how much ammo this episode gives us. No more nightmare description. Man, I'm awesome. Shkabursky! And this one? Actually, no, fuck it. I don't care about darkness blobs, they don't hurt anybody. Unless you walk on them, then they hurt you. What? I totally pulled out the flashbangs! You guys saw that? I fucking pulled the flashbangs out. I wasn't cool. Not cool, guys. Yeah, cool. No. That's a bad. No. Yeah, just fucking knock you off. You have to come all the way back up and Shkabursky. In the fucking head. Oh, more? Well, that's cute. Any more, or is it just the one? Okay, there's a biggie. There's a biggin. Bigaroni. Bigaroni! Oh, well, fuck you too! You know what? Here. Where? Oh, that didn't even reach him. Kill those guys. I killed all three! That was good. I'm patting myself on the back right now, because that was pretty good. I didn't even think it would do that. But I'm gonna keep my shotgun out, because I wanna use it, you know? We're doing good. I can afford to use a little bit of shotgun ammo. Little bit. Ouch, fuck you. What are you guys? Nope. Okay, you know what I'm gonna do? Just in case the other guys are sneaking up on me. Okay. Let me get this one. Oh, you suck! Oh, I walked into that! I'm not sure if I walked into that. Okay, 1, 2, action. 3. Alan should need one blast to kill this thing. And she could burst. Oh! I don't think it hit all the way. There we go. Okay, back to revolver. Okay, let's see what this page has to say.
We can bury the bars in the cell. Of the jail cell. Barry stood behind me, swaying on his feet, looking as ill as I felt.
Agent okay, Barry so they feel ill in the future the for some reason. Sheriff Breaker. Maybe because they're in jail.
Manuscript pages in his hand. He seemed unhinged as he gloated. Well, I've got you now, Raymond Chandler. It's all here. All the evidence, including conspiracy to murder a federal agent.
If I was at this point, like, not to say Alan in the page, but Alan right here, if I was Alan right here and I picked up the page and saw that I was going to be in a jail cell, that Nightingale already captured me, even though I've been running this whole time, I'd just be like, God damn it. God damn it. I'm running through the forest trying to find my wife. And I'm already going to be captured in the future. I just know it. Great news. Okay, so the path is set to the right, but as always, to the left is more goodies. This, though, is 100% a trap. I know I said last time that was 100% a trap. This is definitely a trap. Like, this is, like, you guys see how enclosed I am right now? As soon as I turn my back, it's gonna get really bad. Just no one in the dark. And then as if to drill into my head. Okay, I'm gonna see how close they can get. Boop. Come on. Okay. Take it. Oh, shit. That did not go the way I hoped. At all. But I think I got it, you know? It worked out pretty well in the end. Boop, boop. Worked out pretty well in the end. Okay, we got some flashbangs. So our revolver's slowly dwindling, but we have shotgun and a flare gun, and flares, and flashbangs. Oh, and look at that, there's lights, which means probably more revolver ammo. Hey, maybe even shotgun ammo, we're about to see. And a bit of light. Okay, yeah, revolver ammo. Oh, look at that, we have full revolver ammo. Awesome. And shotgun? Oh, this is too much.
I had no real plan. I was going to do the
camp. And a pump action shotgun? That's what
enough,
I'm talking about.
I told him at gunpoint.
That's what I'm talking about. Okay, so left or right? I know for a fact left has items. Because left always has items. But as you can see from all these lights, we're going to be brutally attacked here in a minute. Yeah. Yep. Brutally attacked. I'm going to save that pump action shot. Oh, nope. See, I got double light. Automatically means fuck you. And a dead and a dead. Ooh, these mad skills. Mad skills. Oh, you guys can't even touch me. You can't even touch me. Okay, here's the barn of lots of death. Reminds me of a barn later, actually, that I'll meet my friends. Oh, shit, okay. Kabushki, and then I can go in. Oh, no, I can just sit right here at the entrance. Okay, if I can lure them in here. Oh, shit, okay, no, not what I wanted. And then backs him off, and then in the face. Come on, buddy. I got some nice treats for you. Come on. It's a rare delicacy, actually, in some countries. It's called shotgun in the fucking face. In the fucking face. The people who gave it to me said it's quite a bang. Okay, I'm just gonna stop. I'm done. Let's just get through this episode. Oh, no! I'm cautious of your douchey. You don't need to tell me that. I know you guys are douchey. Come on. Okay, that's one. Okay. Boop. No, more ammo. Damn it. Dead. And goddamn, we need to refill again. Okay. Well, good thing we have a lot of shotgun ammo, you know. With the pump action! Okay, let's just book it, because we need to keep going. Am I even going the right way? God damn it. I'm not even going the right way. Here we go. This is the right way. I'm kind of tempted to use the flare gun. But they have to get close, is the thing. They have to get close. Okay, come on. Yes! And then use the pump action for these two defense. Come on. Come on, buddies! Come on, okay. You fucking back up! And you die. St- stay on the ground. I see some items and shit over there, but fuck it. Just fuck it. Let's just keep going, you know? We're good on items. You know, like, if we were ever good on items, now would be the time that we were good on items. Oh, I'm glad that the wailing of, you know, moving children in the same is following me. Going.
A cold Lovely. Feeling settled itself in the pit of my stomach.
Crosses, oh, was great, it going dead for Alice? People. Gray. I remember getting attacked here. Yeah.
The graveyard shift may cause cancer.
Oh, they're the warpy kind. They're the twitchy ones. I don't like the twitchy ones. Okay. Sit right here because I can funnel them with using the bridge. Before, they have kind of have their own area. But if I can funnel them, we should be chilling. Yeah, see, because he has to come this way, either left or right. Which means I can kind of herd him into one spot, you know? He has to come to me to attack. I'm defending myself, you know? I'm not trying to attack him. I mean, I am. At the end of the blood. Oh, okay. Yeah, see? They have to get close. I can funnel them. Nah, fuck you. And you're dead. Let's see how well your friend fares, because I know he's stronger. I'm just working him down slowly. Stop being so twitchy and come fight me. I have high ground, twitchy one. No twitchiness to not prevail. Okay, he's hanging back. He's waiting. Maybe he's just not close. Come on, yes! Show me what you got. Come on, show me what you got, come on. I dare you. I fucking dare you. Come on. He's almost there. Just gotta wait a little bit longer. Sounds like he's being very twitchy over on the left-hand side. Like, really, really twitchy! He's so goddamn twitchy! Can't stand it. Come on. Make him be twitchy. It's spreading! Yes! I told you I have the high ground. In the face! He took a whole shotgun blast! Pump action! To the face, my god. What am I dealing with? Thankfully, I can outsmart their twitchiness. They think they can out-twitch me? Oh. Fools! I'm not sure, but I think I'm almost to the end of the episode. I got a feeling. It's more than a feeling. I'm unbelieving that you're in love. Okay, I'm done. Let's see what this page has to say, shall we?
I lifted the page.
Oh, this page!
In it, I lifted the page in front of my eyes and read it. In it,
I lifted the page in front of my eyes and read it. In it,
page in front of my
Megaception!
In it, I lifted the page in front of my eyes and read it. In it, I lifted the page in front of my eyes and read it.
I love that page. Because it's grammatically correct. And it's such, like, super inception. Oh, it just boggles the mind.
The place was dead. A ghost town. Had been for decades.
Oh, no. You guys see that? I see this shit. Dark presence, don't you all, you fucking dig. Drop torch. It backed off when the torch came into play. Interesting. Gotta remember that. Because I've never seen that before. Let's get the next manuscript page. Waking case.
Things were never as simple in real life as in fiction. I had lost count of the times I had wished there'd be a clear reason for my writer's block. Something to fight. Something to lash out on. There wasn't. I was filled with doubt. I was nothing like the hero in my books. Alex Casey had gone through his life with single-minded determination, never wavering from his goal. Even now, I was angry at myself. Angry at Alice. Angry at Barry. I was fumbling and I had no plan.
That's not good. Looks like an abandoned boom town. Looks like they used the logs as their means of production. From what I can guess, but now it's abandoned. I guess we should go back to the revolver for now. Don't see any massive threats, you know. Except for that thing! Ah, shit. Well, good thing I have the water tower. Ah, shit. Didn't work the way I hoped. Hit this one, because it's closer to death. Now, take out this one. Use these beams to protect yourself. You can also recharge your flashlight. Because you know this isn't going to be the only guys that I get possessed here. Bigger shit. This method also works. You just have to keep in mind everything that is being thrown at us. You know? So, all the angles. Die. Not quite dead. And that one's dead. Okay, good, good. We should be good now that the biggest target's dead. Okay, that one died too? No, of course not. Couldn't be that easy, could it? Couldn't be that easy. As I shouldn't be complaining, I have so much goddamn ammo, for the most part. So much ammo? Or like, a little bit of everything? Oh, I didn't realize I had 10 grenades, actually. That will be really effective. Oh shit, Dodge, probably put away my flare gun. Yeah, but I have a little bit of everything, and then my backup stuff's pretty good. And then I have 20 battery. So, definitely Gucci. Definitely Gucci. I'm not sure where I am, though. I think we're almost out of the ghost town, actually. Yep. Just one more inanimate object to fight. One more goddamn. Same technique, just use the fucking tree. Use whatever, like, thing you find. Oh, wait, actually, if I recall, there's a really useful way to do this. I forgot about this. You just go in here! There's a little light which you think would protect you, but not at all. Not at all. But you could totally use the shed to protect you, because it can't get through the shed. Yes. Cheese tactics! Yeah, just go ahead and use full batteries for this. You know, just keep recharging. So I'm pretty sure items like this just regain their strength. It's stuck there. Because I'm so far away. Cheese tactics are the best! Oh yeah! That's my little song about cheese tactics. I like that. And it's dead, we Gucci. Safe haven. Well, that would have been good to know. Well, I actually already knew that, but I wanted to kill those things, so I figured it was worth it. Let's see those bastards die. And look, we get ammo and shit in return. Totes worth. Oh, shit.
Anything outside.
We even got our batteries back. Well, let's see if we can't get all of them.
I feel ill. I managed to make my way downstairs.
Hunting rifle?
There's a shoebox.
Yes. Always switch to the hunting rifle if there's ammo available.
But I managed to reach.
It has less ammo, but it's much stronger. So it's
he writes of muses and creators summoning fabulous
okay,
things
sorry,
from
other
Alec.
I got shit to do. The world of a realm of shit to be.
Things to kill.
Duh, this is the knight that needs to be slayed. I can still hear the TV. That's creepy as fuck. Okay, let's see. Where am I in relation to everything else? I don't quite remember Episode 3 is kind of a blur. There's some major points that I remember. Ooh. Treasure?
The kidnapper had sent me a text.
Treasure!
It was full of spelling errors and insults. It was telling me to hurry up.
I'm on my way! You cool your jets, man. You know what? I'm gonna fucking hit you with a flare gun in the face. Because you know what? That hurts. When you're a Taken, you know, and that's just pure light that just fucking goes so fast that it doesn't kill you because the light, you know, the furious light doesn't kill you as it's going towards you because it's moving so fast. But as soon as it hits the Taken, they're just destroyed. Insta-kill. But you know what? In a human face,
birds.
That would hurt. That would just fucking hurt. Money. Okay. No. Okay. I'm incredible. Those paths are not safe. I guess this is an abandoned town, though, so, you know, you wouldn't think people would be trying these things, not state maintenance or anything. I'm gonna wait. You know, make sure these things are dead. Gosh, fuck you guys. Before I go out on the creaky bridge path that could kill me in a moment if I'm not careful, you know. If I stutter for even a moment, you know, the thing will just drop and I'll just die. Fuck you guys. Staying out beyond the length of my flashlight? Not cool. I'd call that cheese tactics if I ever saw them. Okay, I'm just going. Yes! Yes! Booyah! Booyah! Pretty sure my voice is cracking. I hear birds. I was gonna say, but I don't see birds. I see birds! I think those birds are just chilling for right now. I don't worry about them. I gotta worry about these though. Fuck you! Fuck you! Okay, they're not dead yet. They will be soon. Come on, birdies! Come on, birdies! I got some treats for you! Nah, I lied. You guys are stupid. Oh, the mine? Oh, I hate the mine. Forgot this was a part of... This was a part of 3. Pretty sure after the mine, though, it's done. Like, we come to the end of the episode. I'm pretty sure. It's hard to say. Don't exactly remember. Okay. Right? We need to go right? Okay. Left. And right. But not really right. Left. Okay. There's like a hole. We can at least see out into the open.
Tunnel to the Ultra Plane.
Interesting. I hear my wife's voice down this tunnel. How odd.
Without warning, the headache stabbed at my brain.
I sense powerful presence down this way. Is this wise? Yes! 100% wise!
My wifey needs me! Waifu!
I run, I'll jump!
Alice?
I'm jumping to you, it's much faster by video game logic.
Alice? The lake.
I'm losing it. I gotta get out of here.
Yeah, you're losing it. Of course you're losing it, Wake. Okay, let's read this. While I take off the jacket I'm wearing, because I'm burning up. Oh my god.
Confident and at home in the woods.
Take off this jacket.
You're feeling good, running on beer, ghost stories, and camaraderie late into the night. It did them no good, as they were taken by the dark presence, sucked deep into a darkness far worse than any ghost story they ever told or heard.
Ah, that's much better. I took my jacket off. Feels way better while the thing was going. But I was thinking, oh, it would suck so badly if you were camping. And this happened, you know, you were having a beer, had a nice fire, you know, just made like a hot dog that you cooked on the fire for maybe like half an hour, you know, just trying to get it just right, maybe like 2 or 3, you know, so it's on a plate. You know, got relish, onion. Oh, I'll make myself definitely eating after this. But yeah, you know, you have a hot dog, you're in front of the fire, you know, a little drunk. And the fucking darkness just comes out of nowhere without warning. You're like, oh, I'm dead. That was fun. You know, that's your last thought. That would suck. That's a fear of mine, actually. When you're camping. To get fucked over while you're camping. Because, like, to me, camping is really fun. Like, it's nice to just get away, kind of slay in the wilderness, like, you know, in a protected spot, of course. But, you know, like, at a campsite and just, you know, maybe get a chair out, you know, make a fire, enjoy the night. And, but it's scary, you know, to think that you could get attacked. You know, like, if you get attacked while you're sleeping in your tent or something, there's no protection. You're fucked. You're fucked in every sense of the word, you know, you are fucked. Whether it be, like, just bears or something, you know, maybe some crazy, you know, situation. Animals attacking you for some strange reason. Or, you know, psycho crazy people in the woods who have all other, you know, infinite number of reasons to attack you and or kill you. Maybe rape, maybe steal your stuff, who knows. But I still love camping. It's just a fear, you know. Which happened to those campers? Nightingale.
Behind the closed doors and curtains of his grimy room at the Majestic, the local motel, Nightingale could feel the locals' eyes on him, the unrelenting pressure of their judgment. He forced it out of his mind. For all he knew, they could all be under Wake's spell.
Yeah, Wake's spell.
You do what you have to do to get the job done. He took comfort from the bottle in his hand. Please, he thought. Just let me get through this.
Let me get through this. Oh, he's so fucking drunk. Okay. Hey, ammo. Oh, no. No, no, no. No, 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 no. No, 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 no! Sick hopes just wrenched from me. That's why I got my hunting rifle out. Oh, okay. First things first. Let's pop a flare. Yeah, let's just pop a flare. Okay. Second thing, fuck you guys. Took out two, I'm pretty sure. Third one's hanging back right there. Oh no, hanging out right there. Okay. Boop, boop. Okay, now you son of a bitch. Okay, thank God for shit. Okay, I'm just gonna play Ring Around the Rosie at this point. Until he's vulnerable. Or Hunter Rifle Blast. Because I'm pretty sure these things can only take two of these Hunter Rifle Blasts. That's how strong they are. Oh no. No, 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 no. No, no, no! You stay back! I like you at that distance. You're pretty from a distance, not the book. That's how I'll keep you. Oh no, sorry. He'll just be a memory. Pretty from a distance. Now let's get the fuck out of this mine! God damn! Why are you in these horrified situations? Now you're in a- See, this is what I'm talking about! Now he's in a mine?! Like, yeah, he was at a coal mine before, but now he's, like, literally in the mine? Oh, God. Why do you do this, Alan? Like, how is this the best- Okay. That's the way out. Okay, good. There's no enemies here. Thank God.
Maybe the machinery could help me with that.
Yeah, this is the way out. Okay, so now that we're here, now we just need to... Now it's just Mario platforming to get out of here. Oh, good, good, good. That's up the first level. The first test of knowledge. Move the pillar. Oh, the second step, you're so wise! So wise to know that you can't get up there. You have to go over here. And go around, yeah. The second step. Oh, great wise one. Now, I think I need to unlock something over there. I don't quite remember. Oh, no, no, I'm stupid. There might also be something to unlock here. Here? No, okay. Okay, so move it now up another level to right there. The third test will be able to be passed. Boop-a-doop-a-doo, up the ladder. Onto the platform. In one moment, and yeah, onto the platform. And now, unlock the shortcut. Kick. Oh yeah. So badly, just kicked that thing. It's dropped onto the ground, oh. Or I'm just ready to get the fuck out of this cave. Okay, yep, and the fourth test. You've passed the Test of Cave. Okay, sorry, the Cave Test. Oh, shit. Man, I'm ready for this episode to be done. I really want some pizza, I think. it's late and I want pizza. But hey, we made it out of the fucking... Made it out of the fucking cave. My mind. Back into fresh air. And I think we're pretty close. Oh, my manliness just kicking that board down. One swift kick and it was done. I think there's stuff up here. Let me just check. Give me one sec. Let me check. See what we got, you know? I'm pretty sure there's some flares or something. Yeah, some flares. I think there's a page up there, but I'm just gonna take a cue from life and just take the lemons I found and then just make some lemonade, you know? Before the zombies come out and take my lemonade, if you know what I'm saying, you know? Because sometimes right as you make that lemonade, it finally gave you the lemons, and like right as you make the lemonade, fucking like zombies hit, you know? Some catastrophe. See what I'm saying? Okay, well, I killed some of them. Really? They all ran away because I killed, like, one group? Okay, I'll take that. I'll take that, sure. Pull chain! Oh, with my big manly muscle arms. I realize I have noodle arms. Take the flare gun. Oh, another cable car! Lovely. Lovely. At least I have a shit ton of flares. I'm prepared this time! Oh shit, I almost fell over. I almost fell into my death. Yeah, but this time, I'm fucking prepared, you know? I'm ready. Got the flare gun. Got the flares. Got the flashbangs. I got so much shit. Oh god, I'm so ready for a fight. With evil corrupted taken. Or like a mob, because I have like a shotgun. I have Nona? Alan, why did you think this was a good idea? Okay, just gotta keep him at bay. Okay. I died on the thing. Lame. I died on the thing. Okay, well, at least we're right here.
Oh, great. Another cable
car. Just crashed. Damn it. I died on the fucking cable car. That is lame. That is lame. Okay. Once more into the breach. Fuck you, birds! Fuck you, bird assholes! Fuck you, birds! Ew! Sorry, I curse a lot when I'm scared. I mean, I curse a lot of anything, but I curse a lot when I'm scared. The natural self-defense mechanism. Something I could guess, because I can't defend myself. Ah, shit. My noodle arms. The noodle arms. Oh, no! Okay. Find the thing before I die. Because I had the right idea last time, but I popped it too late. Oh no. The birds aren't even the ones who mess with my thing. It's the fucking trees. What a shame, you know? The fucking trees. And we drop. What about the fucking flare just flew out of the cable car before I did? Guys, I just got here. Is that the welcome you give me? Well, you should guess. Oh, shit! What light through yonder window break? So goes that achievement I just got. Anyways, I forgot I had the torch, the flare gun equipped. Oh,
shit.
My B, I didn't mean to waste it on those guys. Oh well, I still have 7 shots left. I'm good. I don't need to worry about ammo. I keep worrying about ammo, even though we're completely fine. And she's got more. And we got more, and more batteries. Okay, I think I'm really close. Like, we're in the last stretch before we hit the, Yeah, right over there. It was good, folks. It was good. It was a good episode, everyone. But it's time for the final rush. Are you ready? Oh shit, I wasn't ready for that. I was kidding. I was being hypothetical, really. I was not talking about you guys. But I'll take you off. Oh, as soon as he became vulnerable, just in the face. That's what I call him. And Jaborski. Not today. Back to the light. Yeah, Cauldron Lake, we're here. We've made it. I don't know why they're giving me more stuff, but I must be... Okay, I don't think we're quite there yet, but like we're in the final stretch. Yeah, the bridge. Oh, the bridge! We're going in guns blazing. Oh shit, getting off this bridge! We're getting off this bridge before it kills us. Can't run! Oh, wait, I see a thermos. Thermos! It has to do a cinematic viewpoint just to show us how fucked we are. That's disgusting. Get out of my way! Get out of my way, bitches. I'm not playing around. You guys think I was playing around? You guys think I was fucking around? Well, you're about to learn what it means to fuck with Alan Wake! I'm just gonna pick up the thermos. That's how badass I am right now. I'm just gonna pick up the thermos while I'm in the middle of a fight. Come on. Come on, I got a friend for you. It's called Hunting Rifle Blasts. Much better than the Shotgun Blast your friends had earlier. Like your friends probably told you about the Shotgun Blast. I got an even better thing. This is the next level. You're welcome, you're privileged. Bam! Only took two shots. We're good. Nothing can stop us now. Don't stop me now! Having such a good time, getting more ammo. Oh my god, yeah. Okay, then there must be still a little bit more left before the end, because they're giving me more ammo. I just got like two flare gun shots. Yeah, so there must be just a little bit more to go before the end of the episode. We're in the final stretch though. Like, you know how I said it was we were one third of the way before? I'd say we're cabins. Like been no sign of the wakes. Almost into the last bit of that third bit.
End of the road by Cauldron Lake. It made no sense. They must have taken a wrong turn, but there was no sign of them, and the car had been there for hours already. Frustrated, Mott's.
How could they tell the car had been there for hours?
That had once led to Diver's Isle before it sank beneath the waves years ago. The boss wouldn't be happy.
Yeah, you bet the boss isn't going to be happy. You fucking followed him, you know, all the way there, and then as soon as he arrives, you lose him. To be fair, though, it is a pretty impossible situation, you know. The island should not have disappeared the way it did. Well, you know, like, to the locals, the island's already, you know. The island's not there. But Alan didn't. Alan's not a local. You can fool him. Kick my amazing ability legs. If I could just kick shit down, you know, fucking just kick boards down and shit, why am I kicking the Taken, you know? Why not just, like, fucking send them flying? And why can I only run in short bursts if my legs are this strong? I don't understand. Oh, no. I found some creepy shit. Tom. CMNTZ. Cynthia Weaver. I'm sorry, it's not CM. CW. And Tom is saying, "You talk to me on TV. Tom. I miss you, Tom. Did you write this? What? Okay, that's creepy. Tom. I cursed you, Tom is saying. Tom. Shit, okay. She's obsessed. That makes me just all warm and fuzzy inside knowing where I am now. Great. Just great. Shit, I hear some bad stuff. I hear some bad things. I'm gonna get some ammo right now. Shotgun ammo? Dude, I'm way beyond shotgun ammo. That is not helpful. That, however, is. Thought I saw some stuff. Yeah, flares. Nice. Okay, use the flares at the beginning, herd them into a, like, into an area, maybe a corner, and then throw some shit at them. Let's throw some, flare. Yep, and that's what I was talking about. That's why they give you ammo! And then where'd that fucking final guy drop out of, you know? Not cool. Oh, okay, not what I wanted to do, but I'll take it. Okay, that's three dead. That's three dead, and then two more. Easily done. There we go. And then I'll just take this one out with the ammo. There's one. And then you're weaker than he is. Too easy. And then in my next encounters, I'll just use the flares. You know? Because I have plenty of those. Oh, we're so good. So badass. The badass level is just off the charts. Off the scales. Across the mountain ruins. And another thermos. Man, this is just the thermos episode, isn't it? Thermos is everywhere. Thermos heaven. Maybe Alan's dead. I didn't think about that. We're here. We're here.
I could see Cauldron Lake. I thought I could make out the spot where the island and the cabin had been. There was a light near it. It had to be a boat.
It had to be a boat. We're here. This is near Peak Lookout. We're at our objective. One last page.
I was close
now.
I had to get there fast. I dreaded what I would find. I tried.
You'll find the end of the episode. That's what you'll find.
The floor melted away. I was losing control. Dr. Hartman stood in her place. I wanted to hit him, but my arms were jelly.
He just smiled. Like minor noodles! Reassuring we would be great friends, Alan.
I had to give you a sedative. Don't fight it. You went through.
Oh, great! Just injecting right shit into me? That's great. Did I sign a waiver, too? Don't remember that.
You're a patient at my clinic. Have been for a while now.
Sure I am. Because I'm just a psycho-crazy lit person. Psycho-crazy writer that just is in a clinical. That's not me, but
hey,
I'm close.
I'm
close. No. He's talking to someone else. Please, he wouldn't know I'm this close right now.
I didn't know. I swear, I didn't know. We don't have
this wife.
We don't know where she is. She's probably drowned. We just said we had her to make a play ball. You see?
Who is he talking to? Mott? It's here with us. Something makes no sense. And now it's all in turn. Grab the flare because I don't have a machine in my pocket. Not that I couldn't, you know, like, pull out all fucking 15 and just start shucking them. Nope, I just get pulled up by the tornado. Oh, and water. I guess it's better than being in the tornado, you know? And there it ends. And as I drown, fall into the lake, sadly, it's grass, but I fall into it again. As I lose consciousness. Someone sees me. Okay, that was a great episode. I gotta cut it before the music really starts up. Thank you all for watching. This is RaleigHype Plays Alan Wake, Part 3. Tune in for the next episode soon. Thank you all for watching. Like if you like this video, subscribe if you like this video, and I'll see you all in the next video. Bye, everyone!